personally recruited you to the joint task force, but it appears you've gone over to the dark side.
Everything that's supposed to be science.
Our directors asked us to work together.
Well, unfortunately, the FBI has already closed the book on this one.
Even though we can still be more bombs on them.
Look, if the case is closed, what is the fear in letting us speak to Knowles?
Fine. But Nate is the one to interview Knowles as part of the joint task force.
How is that so hard?
Psychologists before. Afghanistan, maybe. After the exposure. Is that why you were medically discharged?
Remind me, that was an honorable discharge.
I'm ashamed.
You were honorably discharged. If it makes
I had nothing to do with that bomb.
How to get in the back of your truck?
I don't know. Someone must have planted it.
Who would do that to you?
How am I supposed to know?
You don't know who put a bomb in the back of your truck?
I told you, I don't know.
Gavin, I'm here to help you. But you have to want me to help you. It starts by you telling the truth.
But don't start with the psychobabble. They had a mark on my head, and now they've got me right where they want me.
Okay. I don't like that, but...
Isn't it obvious? The FBI?
What does the FBI have to do with this?
Where can I start?
Okay, we're done here.
No, I just started interviewing.
The suspect is clearly paranoid. This won't be a productive conversation for anyone.
You can't just...
You can try again later.
Gavin, wait!
What do you think?
His anger's a coping mechanism.
So Gavin is some shell shocked about his turn against his own country.
It's not totally out of the question, but there's something else going on here.
He left the Marines to
escape the nightmare of IEDs. In a sense, from the start, then the war was over.
Well, since this is what I've been confronting his fears. Some sort of aversion therapy.
Only one thing's for sure. Ambrose got spooked.